G'day guys, back again. Now guys, I know I say this a lot, so I'm starting to turn into a bit of a crazy chicken, but every now and again I walk into this little hobby shop near me and I see a couple of these figures. And I'm not a gamer, so I don't play games. Well, I do play games, guys, but you know, we're talking, you know, World of Tanks and some other, you know, well, armor, whatever they call these days. Flashpoint, armed assault armor, I don't know what you call it these days. The Division. But anyway, I digress. Sometimes I just walk past, and even though I don't really paint a lot of these small figures, I see one that I just think just looks absolutely awesome, and this is one of these guys. I mean, it's just a cross between, what is it, you know, a German soldier slash stormtrooper all put into one, and with the machine gun, he looks like he's bloody running around with some sort of saw machine gun, and he's just loaded with gear. I'm just a sucker for that sort of stuff, guys. I think he was around $14 Australian, a lot cheaper than some of the Warhammer stuff, and I just had to pick him up. There's the brand. There's the name there, guys. I mean, can they make their names any longer? Anyway, let's have a look at this little fella. There's your little base that you get with a lot of these little figures. Probably a lot easier, guys, if I'd primed this figure, but I'm not going to build it right yet, so I just wanted to have a squiz at it, and hopefully, I mean, look at that. Look at the detail on this little fella. I mean, look at his legs there. Almost looks like half a mech. And on the back there, well, he's got a cape. I didn't know he had a cape. Or whatever you want to call that thing coming down his... Where's that coming from? Interesting. Interesting. Oh, it's coming from the front. Sorry, guys. I was got a bit confused there. But look at the head on this guy. I just wish they'd make these in 1/16 scale. I mean, this guy in 1/16 scale, especially if it was resin, you know, it would be awesome. You know, I know Nuts Planets is doing some sort of stuff, but I really wish something like Nuts Planet would start doing some figures like this. Absolutely. From the back, the cape just looks a little bit odd, or whatever you want to call this little thing, guys. It looks a little bit odd from the back, if you know what I mean. But from the front, you know, it makes sense. And from the side, makes sense. But I just love the uniform that this guy's got on. I mean, that does look like a saw, doesn't it, guys? Especially the front part. What do you call it? I can't think. Is it a 240? 240 something. I always get confused with the 240B. Is it 249? I don't know. You know, the American machine gun. They've had a couple of versions in there, but like a parasaw or something as well. A couple of different stocks or something like that. You get his little backpack there. A little bit of his MO as well. But, you know, for the size of these figures, apart from just the, obviously a little bit of flash on them, they're actually really nicely done. Now... I mean, it's pretty impressive, really, the detail that they can get on these little figures. He's roughly, oh, I don't know, guys, around, Skippy says he's around close to about 30 mil, 3 centimetres. I'm really glad I picked him up. The amount of detail on this guy is fantastic. Beautiful little figure. Absolute cracker of a pose and gun. And always surprises me. I mean... I just wish that some other companies would pull out some bigger figures like this. Even, you know, 75. I know Andrea did some. You know, they did their Halo figure and they did a couple of the, was it Frontiers or whatever it was called, figures. Like my Sergeant Connor that I've done a video on. But I just wish there'd be some more larger figures of this type out there. All in all, guys, I think this is an absolute cracker of a figure. For $14 Australian, even though he's pretty tiny, I think there's a lot of detail on him. And as I've said, love the armor, the uniform, the gun, the helmet, all the leg pieces around his calves and ankles, the backpack. I think it's an absolute ball buster of a figure. I'm glad I picked him up. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll catch you later.